Every year the NFL offseason takes place, and every year NFL teams pay big money for services of NFL veterans to come in and be a role player, a starter, or sometimes like we see with Tom Brady and Byron Jones this year, a star. However, sometimes teams pay players big money in free agency, and those players never produce, and that's what we're going to be discussing in today's video, is 8 NFL players that secured the bag, only to never produce for the team they signed with. But before we get started, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as all support is very much appreciated. Now let's begin. The first player who cashed in but never paid off for the franchise they signed with is former Seahawks quarterback Matt Flynn. Flynn is most known for a Week 17 start in 2011 against the Detroit Lions, when him and Matthew Stafford went toe-to-toe. The Packers won the game with a score of 45-41, behind Flynn's 480 yards and 6 touchdowns, which both set single-game Packer records. Flynn, of course, was starting for the 2011 MVP Aaron Rodgers, who had led the Packers to a 14-1 record before the game, and they had the number one seed secured. During the offseason, the Seahawks signed Flynn to a 3-year deal that could have been worth up to $26 million. However, in the 2012 draft, the Seahawks drafted a player named Russell Wilson, who earned the starting job, and the rest is history. Flynn was traded the following offseason to the Raiders and was out of the NFL by the end of the 2015 season. The next player who was a complete flop for the team he signed for was DeMarco Murray going to the Philadelphia Eagles. Murray had an outstanding 2014 season as he led the NFL in rushing yards, rushing touchdowns, was the offensive player of the year, and was a first team All-Pro. Even better for him personally, he did this in a contract year and he couldn't have chose a better time to do this. He signed the next offseason with a division rival Eagles to a 5-year, $42 million contract and lasted just one season in Philly before being traded to the Tennessee Titans. During his season in Philly, he averaged a career low in yards per carry with just 3.6, had just one 100-yard game, and had 3 games below 10 rushing yards. DeMarco is now the running backs coach at his alma mater, the University of Oklahoma. The next player who was a complete free agent bust for the team he signed with was when Torrey Smith signed with the 49ers in the 2015 offseason. In 4 years with the Ravens, Torrey caught over 200 passes for over 3,500 yards and had 30 receiving touchdowns. He turned his production into a 5-year, $40 million contract with San Francisco and was supposed to go from being a deep threat receiver to a true number one. Unfortunately, it never happened, and in 2 seasons with the 49ers, he caught just 53 passes for 930 yards and 7 touchdowns. He was released just 2 years into the deal and signed with the Philadelphia Eagles in 2017, where he would go on to become a champion for the second time in his career. He finished his career in Carolina in 2018 and is now retired. I love Torrey Smith, and he is a great human off the field as he does a lot of charitable work, but he was a huge free agent flop for the 49ers. The next player who was a free agent bust was when the Saints signed tight end Kobe Fleener. Fleener, in 4 years with the Colts, had 183 catches for over 2,000 yards and 17 touchdowns. He had 3 seasons at or above 50 receptions as well. The Saints were looking to find a Jimmy Graham replacement as he was a Seahawk at the time, and they certainly did not find that in Fleener. Kobe signed a 5-year, $36 million deal and started just 8 games for the Saints. He caught 50 passes in his first year with the team, which is about what he was producing with the Colts. In his second year, though, Fleener caught just 22 passes and started 0 games and fizzled out of the NFL at just 29 years old. The Saints more than made up for his lack of production, though, as they have one of the best receivers in football in Michael Thomas, and he alone makes up for the production that Fleener did not produce. The next free agent bust we'll discuss is a Redskins free agent signing, and I'm not going to choose the basic 7-year, $100 million Albert Haynesworth one, because if you're an avid football fan, you know about that, and I'm trying to include ones people either forgot about or just didn't realize these players were paid so much money at the time. But in 2006, the Redskins signed safety Adam Archuleta to a then NFL history for a safety, 6-year, $30 million contract. Adam played just one season in DC before being traded for just a 6th-round pick the following offseason. Imagine right now if the Dolphins traded Byron Jones in a year to somebody for just a 6th-round selection. Archuleta started 7 games for the Redskins and he was out of the NFL by 2008, which would have been just his 3rd year into the deal. The next free agent bust we'll discuss is when the Giants signed linebacker LeVar Arrington. In April of 2006, Arrington went from the Redskins to the division rival Giants on a 7-year, $49 million contract, but in the first year of that deal, in Week 7 against the Cowboys, Arrington ruptured his Achilles tendon, and in February of 2007, he was released by the Giants. LeVar then retired following the release, and his production as a member of the Giants included 14 tackles and 1 sack. Injury is unfortunately a part of the game we love, and a ruptured Achilles tendon ended his career at just 29 years old. Arrington was a number 2 overall pick in 2001, and his career was cut short due to this. The next free agent bust we'll discuss is when the Jets signed Darrelle Revis in 2015. In 2015, the Jets signed a 30-year-old Darrelle Revis to a 5-year, $70 million contract, with 39 of that being guaranteed. Corners, like running backs, have a very limited shelf life, and they all lose their battles to age at one point or another. Revis made a Pro Bowl in 2015, but in 2016, quarterbacks had a 91.3 passer rating when targeting him, compared to less than 60 in previous years. After 2016, Revis was released by the Jets, and then he went on to sign a 2-year, $11 million contract with the Chiefs, who had played just 6 games for them before being released. In July of 2018, Revis announced his retirement, and to say the Jets and Chiefs at the end didn't get the Revis Island we were accustomed to seeing would be an understatement, as Revis really fell off towards the end. The final player we'll discuss in today's video is when the Arizona Cardinals signed Sammy Sleeves. Sam Bradford in his career was paid over $129 million and signed with the Cardinals in 2018 for a 2-year, $40 million deal. Sam was a master of getting paid, as for as much as he got paid, he never made a Pro Bowl, an All-Pro team, and he never started in a playoff game. However, the team that got arguably the worst bang for their buck for his services was the Cardinals, as he started just 3 games for them and threw just 2 touchdown passes to 4 interceptions. The Cardinals had drafted Josh Rosen that spring at 10th overall, so the writing for Bradford was almost on the wall before he even got started there. Sam is now retired after earning a lot of money from the NFL, and he maximized his earnings potential while he could, to say the least. Anyways, that's all I have for today's video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, please like the video and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time. Have a great day.